Hello, welcome to Master CRM, and this is my first video which will help you to understand how to create an entity and how to add some attributes and how to configure business rules for the fields that you are that you want to add business rules, or you want to configure, you know, some validations in JavaScript. In previous versions in CRM 2011, we always write custom JavaScript codes to, you know, validate, you know, some fields of our entity. But in 2015 and 2013 of CRM version, we can configure business rules which will, you know, which will add some more value without writing custom codes. User can configure these validations. Now I will show you my agenda of this presentation. I'll show you the business rules configuration, which will include four things, and I will show you how to create a new entity. Then I will show you how to add some fields to that entity, then how to write a custom form script using JavaScript and XRM to validate a field. Then I will configure the same script logic in a business rule so that you will understand how a script can be configured in 2015 of CRM. Now let's move to CRM. This is the CRM application. Here I will go to Dynamic CRM homepage. Of course, every developer is aware of the solution concept, so whatever thing we will do, we will start with a solution, which is a, you know, solution which is a package of different types of customization. Go to here, go to the command bar and select settings, go to solutions, now you will find the solutions view. Here create new solutions, create a new solution and provide a display name of your solution like business rule part 1. Then this name is automatically populated according to your display name. Then select a publisher. Publisher is mandatory when you create solutions. Now in publisher, if you select the default publisher, then every component, every entity or attribute will prefixed as new underscore. But if you want, see here you will find the prefix new, and if you want to customize your prefix, then you have to create a new publisher. Here delete this one and go to the lookup, look for more records and create here new publisher. Give a name like my publisher. The name is automatically populated, and change the prefix as my prefix. Now here you will find a option value prefix. So what is the significance of this? I'll tell you in different video. Now this is out of our scope of this video, so let's park it for later and save this publisher right now. Now we will have the publisher selected and push add. Give a version like 1.0.0.0. Then you can save the solution here. Now you have created this solution, business rule 1. Now our focus is to create a new entity. Now go to entity, components and entity. Select new entity. Suppose let's say student. I will have an entity that is called a student, and ownership let's say user and team, and the name will be my prefix underscore student. Plural name let's set it as students, and select an area let's say it sells. Select process, business process flow as tick. Now I have selected all necessary flags here, and I have saved the entity. It will take time to create an entity because you know it creates a lot of things in background when you create an entity. So now my entity is created. Now go to fields. Now when you add an entity, you will find there are a number of out of the box fields that are automatically created, which is used for you know auditing purpose and entity maintenance you know purpose. So now my point is to create two more fields here. This is my student entity, so I will have something like address. This would be single line of text, and the field let's say it's a text area, then 7 course. Now here you will find the address, this one we have just added, and let's add another field called age. Interested in this, let's say this will be an option set with values like MCA. MBA. BTEC. Now give default value unassigned for the time being. So 7 code the form. Go to the form. Open the main view, main form. Now you will find two default fields on the form, name and owner. Now I will add my two new just drag and drop here, address and interested in field on the form, and save it, press publish. Publish will take time, so hang on. Okay, now it is published. Now close this form, go to view and select the default public view. Here just add your new fields. We will add our new fields that we have added, address and interested in. Let's not save as it's, you just save and close it. Now, so I have created an entity. I have added two fields, new fields in that entity, and I have customized my form to show that two fields on the form, and I have changed the view of the active students to show the new fields that I have added right now. Now publish this solution. And go to the CRM main window. So this is the main window. Now go to here and refresh the screen. Now let's go to the cells that I have selected, cells to view the new entity that we have created. Now you will find the student entity in cells section. Select this entity and you will find no records. Of course, I have not added any records. So if you create new, if you press new button, then CRM will prompt you to add the fields that we have designed. That is, one is name, and let's say name is John Spring, address like Portsmouth, UK, and interested suppose MCA. Now save this. Yes, now I have saved the record. Now go to the sales again. Sales, then click this button to go to the new extension that we have added. So you will find a record called John Spring with address, then interested in, created on. Mind you, this name field I have not added. This name field is the by default, you know, this attribute is automatically added when I created the entity. So I have reused this attribute to provide the name of the student. Now the point is, we have successfully created an entity, we have successfully added two attributes, and we have created a simple record. Now the next point is, I will add some validation here. Now if you click new, then let's say I will give some name like Raji Adelina. Once I give Raji Adelina, if you save it, the form will not prompt you to provide address and interested in, because these two fields are not mandatory. You can set the mandatory option at the time of field design, but there is a way to set these two attributes as mandatory when you give a name in the name field. That can be done through a JavaScript, of course. So let's add some JavaScript. Let's add some form script to change the required level of address and interested in field when you type name. I mean, when you type the name field, giving a value to the name field, the address and the interested in field should be mandatory. Now, let me go to the solution. So, this is our solution, and this is the entity, of course. I'll go to form and open the main form. Yes. Now go to form properties. Now you will find here two sections. One is form libraries and another is event handlers. The first thing you need to add a library, add. You'll find a lookup record. There are a number of scripts that are available in the CRM, which will be shown here to reuse, but my purpose is not to reuse the existing libraries. Rather, I will add new JavaScript here, so press new. Now here, it is asking me to provide the information to create a web resource which will be used for my purpose. Now let's give the JavaScript name as student underscore form script. Student, let's say display name like student form script. Select type as JavaScript. Select text editor. Write down your function here. Function set address underscore interested in is mandatory. So this will be my event handler. Just copy this name, write down something. So here we will write form script, XRM script, to set the mandatory level of interested in and address field. Now XRM dot page dot get attribute it's not page should be xrm dot. If you forget anything, then just go to the blog here, master blog, softchip.com. This is the site where you will find the script reference. Keep this client scripts in Dynamics CRM using XRMR, JavaScript and jQuery, and go down to find out the script here. Just search for get attribute. Get attribute. So this is the line which is required here. Go to your web resource page, paste here xrm.page.getAttribute and give your it should be get attribute. Then in the column you have to provide the name, the field name that you have added. Now it should be my prefix underscore address address. How to find out this? Go to the entity, go to the field, then search for the address. So this is the column, this is the field that we have added, and we have to provide this name, my prefix underscore address, all in small, in that web resource, my prefix underscore address, and shared required label is set required label is required. Now this line will set the address field is mandatory. Copy the same line, just change the column name as interested in equal label required. Now copy this event handler. Okay, so my JavaScript is ready now. Now save and publish the JavaScript web resource that you have created right now. Publish. Close. Now if you go to the window here, you will find this web resource here, then add this. Now we have added the library here, JavaScript library here. Now add the event handler here, select this form. Now close this. It's you should select the field here. I just want to add a script on the field name. When user types the name field, then the script should trigger. Now I will select the field as name and event as on change, and the event handler should be library. It's selected library that I have created right now. Select this, and I have just copied the for function name that I have created in that library. and this enable should be ticked, and do not use this pass execution context as first parameter if it is not needed. I'll tell you why this pass execution context as first parameter is used, but as this is out of the context of this video, so let me skip this right now. Now press OK. Now I have added this form script and event handler here. Now save and publish. Every time you do a customization, you have to save the customization and then publish it. So now I have published this solution. I have just published the entity. I will go to the solution and save the solution again and publish our customization of the solution. Now it is published. Now go to the section where we have the entity in sales and students, create new takes time. Let's load again. Sales student. Not new, then let's now see here. This is the name field, which is mandatory. Here there is a red star. Owner, you will have a red star, but address and interested in do not contain any red star because these are not mandatory set yet in design level. Now when you change the name, let's say when you change the name field, then this address and interested in will be mandatory automatically through the script. Let's add a value here, the Frankenstein. Now click outside of the form, outside of the field. Now you will see this address and interested in are mandatory right now. Now it will not, if you save this form, you will not be allowed to save this form. So it will ask you to give these mandatory values. Now let's say it's England, UK. Again, try to save it. So this will be mandatory interested in right now. Now select anything, MBA, then save it. Now it will allow you to save this form. Now you understand how to create a form script and how to, you know, attach this form script and JavaScript to a field event. Now so you understand, so you can think of the complexity of JavaScript that can be in such a big projects. It's just a simple and very, very basic very basic JavaScript customization I have given right now. But thankfully, latest CRM version comes with, you know, great power of business rule configuration, which replaces custom JavaScript coding in a great way. I'll show you how this happens. Now, I'll show you how to replace this JavaScript that I have written now through some configurable business rule, that is a new functionality that has been introduced in CRM 2013. Now, let's go to the entity itself. So this is the entity form customization. Now open this form, or you can also navigate to the entity customization to do this. So this is the entity. This is the entity where I call it as student. Now go to business rule. You'll find a business rule tab here. And add new business rule. Enter name. You should enter. So this is the form where you can configure business rules. So the most interesting part of this business rule is that it doesn't require a developer to, you know, create business rules. End users, business users can configure these business rules according to their need. So it decreases, it minimizes the dependency of developers. So let's start with the business rule. Let's say set address and interested in as required. So this is my name. Give a description that this business rule mandates the address and interested in field on name change. Now you need to configure the condition here, add condition. Select name field. If name equal to, not equal to, if it contains data, then you can also add, you know, just once you build this condition, you have to commit here, saving the changes. So if name contains data, then action should be set business required. Select this address. So set business required field address as business required. Add action. Set business required, select interested in needs business required, set the changes. So now we have built the same logic that we have written in JavaScript. Now save this. I do not have any else part. Save this business logic. Close the form. Now I have the business rule. Now you have to activate this business rule. Okay, Now go to the entity and go to the form, open the form. Just check the business rule if that is added or not here. We have already this business rule added. Now just double click this name field. Just double click this name field. Here you will find the properties of the field and go to the event. You will find a event handler here. Open this and just untick this enabled option so that for the time being we will stop the JavaScript event handler for the field. Press OK. Now go to the business rule and add this business rule. So close this, press OK, save, publish. Close this form. Go to the main form and go to the view. Go to the sales, then student, then add new. Write something like Gary Bradford. Now you see this is working here. Got it. See, I have visible the script here and configured the business rule. Now it's working. Now save it. It will ask to give address and to be satisfied, let's refresh the form again. Select sales. go to students, add new, now this address and interstate are not mandatory. Now select NM, given name here, candidate port. When you go out of this field, these two address and interstate field will be mandatory. Now you can set here and you can now save it. Now I'm very much sure, pretty much sure that you understand how scripts can be configured in business rule, which will minimize the development effort or the customization effort that we are doing. Now undoubtedly we can delete the web resource that we have created. We can go to the form and open this form. Form properties. Now select the name, delete this, select this event handler and remove this, and remove this library, then press OK, save and publish. Now I have removed the event handler and removed the script library that I have written. Now close this form. Save and close. Go to the solution. Go to web resource. Now select this web resource and delete it, because I don't need anymore. Delete this web resource because I have configured in business rule, so I don't need this scripts anymore. Because if you not remove the script library that you have added in an entity, then unnecessarily it will take time to load all web resources. So now I have removed the web resource. I will do a publish and customization. And close the solution. And I'll go to the main share window here and I will refresh the main screen again to check if that business rule still works or not, because I have removed the JavaScript and deleted the web resource. Go here, select sales, student, new, then let's say David Cook. It's working. Address and interstate in are mandatory right now. Now it is haven't. Okay. Interested in BTEC. Save it. Now we understand that how to create an entity, how to add some attributes, and how to work with JavaScript, which will validate some fields using XRM script, and how to replace that JavaScript in business rule configuration. Now, don't you think it's interesting? Yes, it's interesting. And now you can think of more complex customizations using business rules. So Now we have covered these things. We have created an entity. We have added some new fields. We have written some form scripts to validate fields, and we have configured business rule to replace the custom JavaScript. Thanks very much. And next time I will try to focus on some new features of CRM 2015 and 2016, which will help us in a great way. Thanks. See you. And of course, I must say, please visit this blog, softchief.com, which is dedicated to dynamic CRM, and which provides a lot of information regarding, you know, best practices, resources related to CRM. So go through it and learn it and like it, give comments, and anything else, give comments. Thanks, bye.